Seismic waves travel at different speeds through different materials. In this two-layer model, two wavefronts leave an impact at the same time, but the lower layer is faster. When an explosion or impact occurs at or near the surface, waves travel away in all directions. In a uniform medium, they would travel straight paths away from the source. But what happens if they hit a boundary between faster and slower layers? Waves react at the boundary according to Snell's law, such that when energy arrives at a boundary, some of the energy refracts in the lower layer to speed up or slow down, depending on the media. Snell's law describes how seismic ray paths bend as they travel from one material into another. They bend toward vertical when going from fast to slow, and bend towards horizontal when going from a slower to a faster material. When the rays are refracted 90 degrees from normal, they travel along the boundary in the fast layer. Ray paths aimed at the layer at more than a critical angle will have all the energy reflected back to the surface. This is known as supercritical angle. Rays that strike the boundary at less than the critical angle, subcritical ray paths, have most of the energy refracted or bent to travel at a shallower angle in the fast layer, with less energy reflected upward. The critical angle marks the angle where the wave is refracted parallel to the boundary and travels along the upper surface of the fast layer while sending a series of rays, known collectively as the head wave, back to the surface at the angle of the initial direct wave. When we look at all the waves, we see that a wave traveling along the critical ray path can actually reach a geophone before a direct wave traveling a shorter path in the slower layer.